You have to go to where you're loved, and wherever you're loved, you take care of those people, or you show them the gratitude, the appreciation. That's where you go to. You don't go to places where there's negative energy, or you'll force yourself amongst people because of certain things. No. I guess my nature is kind of like from my dad, in the sense that he's a very calm, very gentle person. We'd go out for rides in the evenings, and then he always had a jazz CD on. You know, he would listen to George Benson, El Clue, Quincy Jones. So Quincy Jones actually is one of the main guys that I used to follow, you know, because of my dad. You know, my dad has all his albums, literally all of them. Do your thing in your time. Pretty mama made me fall. When it was my mom's turn to take over the sound system, it was more up-tempo, and my mom was a very jovial, funny, you know, likes to crack a joke here and there type of person, loves to laugh, and so her music was more, you know, energetic. And then, you know, the high life, she used to listen to a lot of high life, Kodja Entry, there's people like CK Man. That's literally what music was like in our household, to be honest. Maya, you're the fuel to me fire. Oh my, you're the fuel to me fire. Oh my, you're the fuel to me fire. Oh my, you're the fuel to me fire. But fast forward to like maybe secondary school, I used to beatbox a lot. We used to do rap battles, and I was the one who would be, you know, beatboxing or banging on the table, making the beat. I used to make like crazy sound effects, car sirens and stuff like that. So when I got older, beatboxing was just normal for me. So this is 2007 times, and this is when I'm in Ghana now. I got free loops installed on my laptop. You know, there were some producers in Ghana at the time who I would just go and sit with them. Producers like J-So and EL, Panji Anoff, you know, who were producers in Ghana doing their thing as well. But then when I started to, you know, build commercial success with Mr. Easy and, you know, a few of the other acts that I've worked with, and creating a different sound to what was the norm, that's when people started to pay attention.
Okay, straighten. My enemies leave faceless. Can't slip, can't leave no traces. Put faith in the books like Mason.
My hope is we're able to start what our forefathers weren't able to complete or do at all. You know, I feel like Phil Akuti, Tony Allen, all these names are popular only because that we've continued to make noise about them. And so people again begin to do their research furthermore into the genre of music.
Young boy move like man at old school. Geez, I know, say they don't know you. So we roll through your ends like man a low cool. Like, okay, you're bad now, cool. Go on and do what a bad man do. I know geez that will test that gangster. Make man lean that criminal smooth. Like, whoa, mic to mouth, check to check. And I still go city to city repping the set like.
The reason why I call it color is because in Africa or in Ghana, we have this term which says, show me your true colors. So it's me literally showing my true color to people through my music, that actually this is what I listen to, these are my influences, and this is what I can do. It's one of those albums that's literally a feeling album, which you understand, you know. We really worked hard on it, you know, the instrumentation, you know, making sure that it actually touches people's souls, because music is all about feeling, and at the end of the day, it's feel good music, and I just want everybody who listens to the album to have a good feeling when they listen to the project. And I just like to spread a lot of positivity through my music, and it's a good vibe. And if you put the CD in your car, or you play it on your phone and you listen to it quietly, you're just gonna be in a zone where it's gonna get you thinking happy thoughts. But when you think deep about it, the indirect messages are in there.